Well, Hawaii is gaining national attention, not for its beautiful beaches, but for the people who protect those who are enjoying the beaches. Men's Health magazine is featuring Oahu's North Shore lifeguards in an issue that will soon be released. The magazine chose the lifeguards after it heard about their life-saving rescue and resuscitation of a surfer at Waimea Bay last December. Well, we wanted to get to know these men in the red shorts a little better, so we sent out KITV4's Shane Enright to see what they do.
The North Shore of Oahu produces some of the most powerful surf on the planet. The potential for loss of life is undeniable.
It's the most exposed, dangerous coastline there is in the world.
On a calm summer day, we met three North Shore lifeguards featured in an upcoming issue of Men's Health. At 25 years old, Ka'ivi Berry says he stays physically fit to face the daily challenges as a lifeguard.
It's one thing to get yourself out of it, but when you have another person with you, it's a whole different ball game, you know?
To stay on top of their game, all city and county lifeguards get an hour break to work out. But before stepping into a lifeguard tower, all recruits undergo intense physical and medical training.
We put them in all sorts of different conditions, surf, caves, cliffs, shore break, open water swimming.
As a North Shore lifeguard for 7 years, Brian Phillips has maintained a healthy lifestyle to keep up with the changing ocean currents.
I surf, I mountain bike, I run, I'll swim, I'll do pull-ups, push-ups.
So in order to get a closer look at what it's like to be a North Shore lifeguard, I decided to give it a shot. Jet ski operator Brendan Shea showed us how lifeguards train to pull swimmers out of trouble. From the time the lifeguards are hired to when they retire, they must pass annual fitness tests. Also, if a lifeguard is off the job for more than 30 days, he or she is reevaluated to ensure every lifeguard meets the required standards.
The general population, you know, in the United States at least, has gotten less fit as time has gone on. And, you know, we have to be more vigilant in our efforts to prevent and rescue them.
The lifeguards say although it is a big responsibility, it is a job they are fortunate to have.
I didn't intend for it to be, but it became a dream job, and it's been 21 years, and I'm very, very happy about that.
Reporting from the North Shore, Shane Enright, KITV4 News.